Generative AI is a very popular field right now. A new large model or new tool is developed almost every day. Today, we're gonna handle two of these tools, PandasAI and Groq. We speak our data with PandasAI. To do this, we leverage the Groq Free API. As you know, it's hard to work with data, but these tools help us analyze data easily. PandasAI is nothing but a Python library that allows you to perform data analysis tasks. You can chat your data with this amazing tool. Using this tool, you can ask questions to your data in natural language. Also, you can generate plots to visualize your data. On the other hand, Groq is nothing but a tool that allows you to use large models such as Llama 2 and Mixtral. Groq uses the language processing unit system. This system offers super speed and efficiency for AI inference. This means that you can perform your generative AI projects very quickly. You can leverage the Groq API for free. Let's take a look at our roadmap in this video. First, we'll load our dataset with Pandas. After that, we'll initialize a large model with the Groq API using LangChain. Lastly, we'll speak with our data using this large model. Nice! We've seen the topics we cover. Let's start with setup. First thing first, we're gonna create a virtual environment with Conda. Let's open our terminal and write conda create. To give a name, let's use dash n, and then let's name gen AI. I already created this. After that, we'll activate this environment. Let's do this. Conda activate gen AI. Okay, our environment is ready to use. What we're gonna do now is install the tools we'll use. To do this, let's create a requirements file. We're gonna click on the new file and then name it requirements.txt. After that, let's write the tool we'll use here. To read our data, we'll use pandas. To use generative AI, let's get pandas AI. And then to access the Groq API, we want to install LangChain, Groq, and Python.env. For now, these tools are enough to analyze data. Now, we're gonna install these tools. To do this, let's use pip install -r. Let's write requirements.txt. Let me run this command. Yeah, loading started. There you go. Our tools are ready to use. To write our codes, we're gonna create a notebook file. Let me click on the new file and then give a name. Pandas AI with Groq. .ipymb. Let me select kernel, press geni. Yeah, our file is ready. It's time to read our data. The dataset we're gonna use is about the population of countries. Let's load our dataset with pandas. First, let's import pandas. Import pandas spd. The dataset we're gonna use is country populations. Keep in mind that you can find a link to this dataset in the description below. Let's have a look at this dataset. As you can see, this dataset includes the population of several countries. What we're gonna do now is read this dataset with the readCSV method. Data equals pd.readCSV. Let's pass population.csv. Okay, our dataset is ready to dive in. Let's take a look at the first file of the data. To do this, we're gonna use the head method. Data.head. There you go. You can see countries and populations. Nice! Our dataset is ready. The model we're gonna use is the mixer model. To access this model, we're gonna use the Groq API. First, let's set our Groq API key. To do this, we're gonna leverage the load.env method in the .env tool. Let's import this method from .env. Import load.env. To get our API key with this method, we're gonna create an env file. Let me click on the new file and then give it .env. What we're gonna do now is set our API key here. Let's write Groq API key. Now we need to give your API key. You can get an API key from the Groq website. To get this API key, go to Groq Cloud and then click on the API key button. We can create an API key for free. To do this, let me click the Create API Key button and then give a name, PandasAI. After that, copy this key. Don't worry, I'll delete this key before loading this video. We need to paste this API here. One thing we're gonna do is import this API key as an environment variable. To import this API key, let's use the load.env method. Load_.env. Let me run this cell. Awesome! Our API key is ready to use. What we're gonna do now is initialize the model with the chat Groq class. First, let's import this class from LangChain Groq. Let's call the chat models import chat Groq. After that, let's initialize an object LLM equals chat Groq. We can use two models with Groq. These are Mixer and Llama 2. We want to utilize the Mixer model. To do this, let's set model name and then pass Mixerl 8x7b 32768. Next, let's set our API key. To do this, we're gonna use the auth module. Let me import this module. Import auth. After that, let's set the API key parameter. API key. Let's pass auth.environ. After that, let's give our Groq API key variable. Groq API key. Let me run this cell. There you go. Our model is ready to use. To chat with our dataset, we're gonna use the Smart Data Frame class in PandasAI. This class allows you to interact with a single data frame. First, let's import this class from PandasAI import Smart Data Frame. Let's convert our data into Smart Data Frame. Let's say df equals Smart Data Frame. Let's pass our data. Let's set the config parameter. Let's give LLM and then pass our model LLM. Nice! Our dataset is ready to chat. Let's go ahead and start to talk to our data. The first question we're gonna ask is to find out the top 5 countries by population. Let's say df chat. Let's write which are the top 5 countries by population. Let me run this cell. There you go. You can see the top 5 countries here. Note that our code ran very fast. This is because the Groq API is 15 times faster than other API keys. This is incredibly fast, right? As you can see, it's simple to explore data with PandasAI. All we need to do is pass our prompt. Let's go ahead and calculate the total population of the top 3 countries. Let's say df.chat. Let's pass first sort the countries by population and then calculate the total population of the top 3 countries by population. Let me run this cell. Here you go. Our model calculated the total population of the top 3 countries. Let's go ahead and create a bar plot. To do this, df.chat first sort countries by population and then create a bar plot of the top 5 countries. Let me run this then. There you go. You can see the bar plot showing the top 5 countries. Lastly, let's create a pie plot. Let me copy this code and then paste it here. We just set over here. Let me write pie. After that, we're gonna run this cell. There you go. As you can see, the pie plot is drawn. Yeah, that's it. In this video, we covered how to use the Groq API key with PandasAI. As you can see, the Groq API key is very fast. As mentioned, you can also perform other data science steps such as data cleaning and feature generation using these tools. Note that the link to this notebook in the description. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.